Welcome to Lab12, Day 4. In this lab, we will try to understand what exactly is MDI, or multiple document interface. That's a full form of MDI. Okay. Now, why do I need the MDI first thing? Now, if you see, till now, what we have done is, if I do a control F5, this is our screen, right? And whenever we type whatever on the screen, we are getting a new screen, where we preview it, right? Now the problem is all these forms over here, right, are scattered. In other words, someone is here, someone is here, and they are not organized actually. When I say organized, means, for example, look at our Visual Studio IDE. Here you can see all these menus over here. So if I click on build, it actually goes to a build. If I click on project, I can see all the sub menus in it, right? So I would like to go and organize my complete application in terms of such kind of menus. So I would like to have a menu something called as file here, and then when you click on the file and you'll get a menu called as enter customer, okay? And then from the enter customer, I would like to go and pop up this form which I've just recently created, okay? This form. So how do I do that? Okay, so for that, we can go and create a very special type of form called as the MDI form. So in order to add the MDI form, click on view, click on solution explorer, and go and add a new item. And if you browse down below, HIJKLM, you can see that there is something called as MDI parent form. Okay, so let's go and add this, and then I'll tell you what exactly is this MDI parent. So I'm going to say here, let's say I'll say MDI parent, give the same name, say okay. So in the first look itself, you can judge very clearly what's the use of MDI parent. The first thing is that the MDI parent actually provides you with a very nice menu bar here, where you can go and plug in your forms. So we have currently two forms here. One is this customer form and the other one is a preview form. So we can go and go here and put invoke those forms from these menus. That's one important use. So what I'll do is, first let me go and do that. So I'm going to go and click on this new here. Now what you have to do is click on file and click on new. So from here, sorry, let me go here again. Let's go to the text there. Right, so I'll say here that from here I would like to go and invoke enter customer. Okay, now when a person goes and he clicks on this enter customer here, right, it will actually go and invoke this form, that is form1.cs. okay, the form1.cs is nothing but basically it's a customer data entry form. Now let's go and give a reasonable name to this form. So I'll say here FRM create customer, so that we don't have confusion. Naming convention is very important. FRM create customer. Okay, so I would like to go and pop up this FRM create customer, from this menu which I have created here called as enter customer. Okay, now if you double click on it, you can see that there is some kind of a ready-made code there, and this ready-made code was put in order to create a new form. So currently we don't want this code. But here what we want is, we want to go and invoke this FRM create customer from here, right? FRM create customer form. So in order to go and invoke the FRM create customer form, start typing FRM customer data entry. Now this FRM create customer .cs is a physical name. If you go internally, for some reason, I don't know how that has happened, but the name of the form is actually FRM customer data entry screen. Okay, so we'll type here FRM customer data entry screen. Now this syntax, which I'm showing now, for now just type as it is. We'll talk about this syntax more when we talk about object-oriented programming. Okay, so for now just say that, okay, FRM customer data entry screen object obj is equal to new FRM customer data entry screen. Okay, and we'll say here obj dot show. Right, so this syntax, what it does is, the first line actually goes and creates an object of our form, okay, and the second syntax invokes the form. So now let's do a control F5 here. So I'm going to do a control F5. Control F5. Now this is not what we want, right? We want that MDI form to pop up first. And this form should pop up, you know, when somebody clicks on the menu of the MDI form. So in order to go and change, you know, which form will start up first, you need to go to your solution explorer, and there is a file called as program.cs. Now this program.cs is nothing but it's a startup file. This file actually tells, you know, which form should be invoked when your application starts running. So you can see over here we are telling him that you have to invoke FRM customer data entry screen, and that's why the customer data entry screen is popping up first. So let's go ahead and say that we don't want to start this form first. We want to first start the MDI parent. Okay, and now let's do a control F5. So now that's much better. You can see that our MDI parent has started first. And now let's go and click on file, and let's go and click on new customer. And you can see that the customer data entry screen is now seen. Now that is much better. So in other words, you know, your project is now organized properly. It has menus, and within those menus, you know, your forms are getting popped. But still we are having certain problems here. What is the problem? The problem is, you know, this customer data entry screen, you know, you can see that it actually moves out of the MDI parent area. In other words, now this is my MDI parent, you know, but my customer data entry screen can go anywhere it wishes, which I don't want. I want that this customer data entry screen, you know, should not go outside the area window of MDI parent. Okay. So how do I go and ensure that, you know, this form actually does not move outside this area window? Okay. For that, you know, we have to create the customer data entry screen form as a child form of this MDI parent. So for that, you know, we have to put just one simple line of code. The form object what we have created, right, we have to say over there obj.mdi parent. So we have to say that this form, you know, that is your FRM customer data entry form, this form actually belongs to the MDI parent. So you have to say that, okay, the parent of this form is this. Now this means actually this object of MDI parent. So what will happen is when you click on the menu, this show new form function will run, and this show new form function, what it will do is it will create the object, and it will say that, okay, this form which is running will run inside, you know, the what you call the boundary area of MDI parent. So you can see that I, you know, by using this, I'm saying that this form is now a child form of this MDI parent. Now if I go and run this application, if I say control F5 here, and if I click on this enter customer, and now if I try to move this form outside, right, you can see that it doesn't go outside. Okay, if I minimize this form, you can see that it actually is seen you know, like a task window, you know, inside the MDI parent itself. So with this, what happens is, you know, your form is now getting better organized. It is not just lying scattered on the air, right? So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we saw that how we can use MDI parent to create menus, as well as how we can use MDI parent to ensure that your form lies, you know, in a proper container like a MDI parent. So as said previously, that there are two things, you know, when we are doing this labs. One is we are doing the labs, and the other ones also we are going through some important concepts of .NET, right? So, you know, with this lab also, I would like you to go and see a very important concept called as delegates. Delegates are nothing but they are pointer to functions. So what I would expect is, go and log into your Questmon video account. There are three great videos, you know, which we have. One video which explains what problem does a delegate solve. Second one, you know, it explains what is a multicast delegate, which is actually a different form of delegate. And third, you know, it's one more improvised form of delegate called as events. So I advise that, you know, go and see this three fundamentals so that we understand delegates and events. Now remember that, you know, these fundamentals, it is very difficult to go and complete in the lab. Why? Because you know, our lab tutorials will then become very, very large. So that's why I don't want to include these things in the practical things what we are doing now. But these things are equivalently important. You know, when you go and stand in the industry, people ask about these concepts. So labs, concepts, labs, concepts, you know, that's the way we will move. Thank you very much.